Good morning, dear students. Today I am going to start a topic from the book The First Flight. The topic of this book is A Letter to God. You know, A Letter to God is a story of a farmer. The name of this farmer is Lencho. You know, Lencho was a poor farmer. He was living somewhere in a valley. The region of that valley was very fertile. He used to grow crops there, and his life based on the crops which he used to grow there. His family, his children, all of their life were based on agriculture. You know, he was a farmer and he used to grow crops. You know, once there started hailstones, it began to fall upon his crop, and these hailstones destroys his crops. He was very sad to see this situation. He was in melancholy. He could not sleep throughout the night. Then he began to think how to solve this problem. At last there came an idea into his mind. The idea was a help. From where he should seek a help? This was the question which was running into his mind. In the end, he thought that this help should be taken from God. That's why he write a letter to God. Now I am going to our topic. The topic is A Letter to God. You know, this was the overview. Now we are going to discuss the whole story, A Letter to God. You know, this story is written by G.L. Funes. G.L. Funes is talking about a character. The name of this character is Lencho. You know, before going to this story, I would like to discuss the title of this story. The title of this story is A Letter to God. It means a character is going to write a letter to God. You know, in ancient time, letter was a medium to communicate. It was a very important medium to communicate from one person to another. A person who is very far away from here, if one wants to communicate, he will communicate or she will communicate with the help of letter. The same situation was there with Lencho. He was sad, he was in melancholy as his crop had been destroyed. So now we are going to start this story. You know, Lencho was a character and he was living into a valley. His house was situated on the crest of a low hill. He was living there happily with his family. He grew a crop on that year. The crop was very wonderful. It was very rich. It was about to ripen. You know, when it was about to ripen, it needs a little water. So he was thinking from where he should give water to his crop. He was totally waste on rain. So he used to sit into the courtyard of his house and he used to look into the sky that it should rain. You know, no clouds were visible. It passed a long period. You know, one evening when he was sitting into his courtyard and he was looking to the northeast, there began to emerge some clouds. The huge clouds were seen by Lencho. The huge clouds were seen by Lencho into the northeast region. You know what happens? By seeing these clouds, his heart, his mind filled with joy. He was happy. You know, after a few minutes, it started raining. When it started raining, he came out of his house in the open region. He came out of his house to feel the drop of rain on his body. After feeling that rain, he returns and he speaks. You know, this rain is not rain. It is the rain of wealth in my crop. The big drop of this rain is of 10 cents and the small one is of 5 cents. You know, in South America, cent is a money which is, you know, in use. So it is of big drop, he exclaimed like this, and he again go back into his own courtyard and he was enjoying to the rain. You know, suddenly there came a change in the weather. It stops rain and the wind begin to blow. Okay, so he was sitting again into his courtyard and he was happy. Suddenly there came a change into the weather. Dear children, हुआ क्या कि अचानक बारिश बंद हो गई. And what happens there? Again the slow wind begin to blow. And this slow wind change into the fast wind. With this fast wind, there begin to fall, or there begin to fall hailstones. You know, there was the rain of water before this. Now there is the rain of hailstones. Seeing that rain, he was sad. Lencho was sad. He became very sad. And he began to say, what is going on now? And he proclaims, God, it is really sad. Wo kehne laga, Ishwar, ye to sach much kuch galat ho raha hai. It is really sad. It is a sad event. In his joyful life, he was thinking that if it will rain, he will get a rich crop. But now that rich crop is going to destroy by these hailstones. So he was sad. He says to that woman who was working beside him that if it will remain continue, it will be very harmful, it will destroy everything. Now he was happy before this, now he was sad. His joy changed into melancholy. You know why? Because of these hail stones. You know that the rain of hail stones remain continue up to 1 hour. After 1 hour, it stops. Lencho came out of his house and looks into that valley. He looks into the valley. You know, that valley was fully covered with hailstones. It was fully covered with hailstones. It was not looking green, but it was looking white. It was looking white. Why this valley was looking white? Because whole valley was covered with hailstones. Whole valley was covered with hailstones. That's why it was looking white. Nothing was visible beside hailstones. You know what happens? Lencho looks everywhere and he reaches into his field. There he was with his son. Son was also with Lencho there into that field. He reaches in the middle of his field and looks everywhere. No leaves of plant was visible. Everywhere there were hailstones. Everywhere there were white snow. Nothing was visible. No green leaves was visible. No green leaves was visible. Seeing this situation, Lencho became sad. He began to say that if locust come, it would have left more than this. लोकस्ट यू नो टिड्डी होते हैं, इट इज़ जस्ट लाइक बिग बीज, बड़ी बड़ी मक्खियों की तरह दिखाई देते हैं। तो ये इन एंशियंट टाइम सच लोकस्ट यूज टू डिस्ट्रॉय क्रॉप्स, प्राचीन काल में इस तरह के टिड्डी आया करते थे और फसलों को नष्ट कर दिया करते थे, ये फसलों को काट दिया करते थे, एंड द होल क्रॉप कम टू इट्स एंड, उसका अंत हो जाता था। तो वो कहता है इफ इट वुड कम लोकस्ट दे वुड हैव लेफ्ट मोर देन दीज हेल स्टोन्स, तो उन्होंने ज्यादा छोड़ा होता इन हेल स्टोन्स से, इन्होंने तो बर्बाद कर दिया, दे हैव डिस्ट्रॉयड द होल क्रॉप, दे हैव डिस्ट्रॉयड माई जॉयज, दे हैव डिस्ट्रॉयड my happinesses after seeing his destruction he returns from there he comes back to his house in the night he could not sleep he remained restless throughout the night and he was thinking how to get support for this year From where he should get help for this year, how to pass this year, because whole crops have been destroyed, nothing was into his house to eat for this year. On the other hand, in the coming season, he had to sow his field also. For that he need money, and money was not, because his crops have been destroyed. So how he will sow? These questions were running into his mind in night while he was about to sleep. So he could not sleep. In the end, he thought there came an idea into his mind. The idea was a help from somewhere. Once again, there is a question, who will help in this difficult situation? You know, people help them who are not in difficulty. When you are in difficulty, people will avoid you. They will not come to you to help. You know, जब आप परेशान होते हैं तो लोग पहले आपसे दूर हो जाते हैं और आप खुश होते हैं, आपकी लाइफ अच्छी चल रही होती है, नंबर ऑफ पीपल विल कम, अनेकों लोग आएंगे, एंड दे विल से आई डू यू वॉन्ट एनी थिंग फ्रॉम मी, कहने आएंगे मुझसे आपको कुछ चाहिए, वैन यू आर इन नीड, लेकिन अब जब आप जरूरत में है दे विल नॉट कम टू हेल्प यू, आपकी मदद करने नहीं आएंगे। तो लेंचो यही सोचता है, लेंचो इज थिंकिंग हु विल कम टू हेल्प मी, इन द एंड देयर कम्स एन आइडिया इन टू हिज माइंड, ही बिगिन टू थिंक एज गॉड क्लोजेज वन वे He opens the other. वो सोचने लगता है कि ईश्वर अगर एक दरवाजा बंद करता है तो दूसरा दरवाजा जरूर खोल देता है. He opens the other way. दूसरा दरवाजा खोल देता है आदमी. If you have faith in God, अगर आपको भरोसा है किसमें? God में. तो we need to have faith in God. If we will have faith in God, we will get the way. Even though one way has been closed, the other will be opened. This happened there. यही वहाँ होता है. Lencho decides to take help not from men but from God. He thinks that God will help me. Because God has created me. He is almighty. He will come to help me. ये सोच बैठता है. यही चीज, द सेम थिंग शोज दैट लेंचो हैज अ फेथ, लेंचो हैज अ फेथ इन द जस्टिस, इन द जस्टिस ऑफ गॉड. यही चीज, द सेम थिंग शोज दैट लेंचो हैज फुल फेथ इन द जस्टिस ऑफ गॉड. ईश्वर का न्याय निष्पक्ष होगा. किसके साथ? विद लेंचो. ही पुट दीज नोशंस बिफोर हिम एंड ही बिगिन टू वर्क, और उस पर काम शुरू करता है. एंड व्हाट वाज द वर्क? द वर्क वाज अ लेटर टू गॉड. देन ही डिसाइड टू राइट अ लेटर टू गॉड. फिर वो सोचता है कि अब आई विल राइट अ लेटर टू गॉड. क्यों लेटर लिखेगा? विद अ डिमांड. ही विल पुट his needs before God and God will satisfy them. ईश्वर उनको क्या करेगा, पूरा करेगा. God will fulfill his needs. ईश्वर उसकी जरूरत को क्या करेगा, पूरा करेगा. By this idea he moves forward and he reaches into the post office. वो post office पहुंचता है. He took a pen and paper and write a letter there. He writes a letter to God. वो एक letter लिखता है और किसको लिखता है, ईश्वर को लिखता है. By having a demand of 100 pesos. What was his demand? His demand was 100 pesos. He put a demand of 100 pesos before God. He dropped that letter after writing that letter and giving an address to God. He put that letter into the mailbox. That letter was taken out by the post office employee. He reads the letter. As he reads the letter, he was shocked and surprised. What was written there? The address was a letter to God. He was thinking that he had not seen this address in his life, in his working life. That's why he took that letter and put on the postmaster's table and says, see, this is the letter to God. Do you know this address? Postmaster reads the letter. And all the post office employee with postmaster begin to laugh upon this silly demand to God. In the end, postmaster becomes serious. He began to think on the faith of that writer who was writing that letter, who has written this letter. He was very serious. Postmaster becomes serious and he decides that I will keep his faith. I will secure his faith in God and I will send him money. Whatever the money he has demanded, we shall try to send that. And with postmaster, all the post office employees collect a little amount from their salary. And they put that amount into an envelope and send to Lenchu. Lenchu again reads, take that envelope and he take out the money, counts the money and he shows no slight, no surprise after counting that money which came from God. He was thinking that this money came from God. He was not surprised because he demanded 100 pesos while it was not 100 pesos. So he was thinking, I have demanded 100 pesos from God and God had not sent him that amount. So he was not surprised. He was not happy. He began to think, God cannot commit mistake. God had sent me 100 pesos. But these post office employees have played a game of trick. They have stolen his money. They have stolen 30 pesos. They have sent him only 70 pesos. So again he reaches, by keeping this into his mind, he reaches on the to the postmaster and ask for pen and paper. Again he write a letter. After writing a letter, he sealed that letter. You know, into this letter he write, the amount which you have sent did not reach me 100 pesos. It reached only 70 pesos. Why this? I cannot bear my expenses for this year. If you want to help me, you send the remaining amount. Again he says, when you send the remaining amount, you send it not by mail. You send it directly to my account. Because if you will send this amount by mail, these post office employee again is stole from there. So you send it directly in my account or in my hand. Don't send it by post. He write this letter and again drop that letter into the mailbox. As he drop that letter into the mailbox, one of the post office employees took that letter and again reads the letter. All of them were shocked and surprised. Why? Because the letter was written and they were saying that you should send me the remaining amount. He was saying you should send, he was complaining against God's mercy. He was blaming the post office employees, even though the post office employee helped him by sending 70 paises. It left only 30 paises, they could not send, but he was blaming them and he was praising to the mercy of God. You know, after dropping that letter, he set out from there. Post office employee began to discuss with each other what should be done. You know, this was the faith of Lencho in God. Now I am moving to the moral of this story. You know, if we talk about faith, if you have faith, you will be rewarded. Faith should be, man must have faith, either one or other. If you will not have faith, you will not get reward. You will be sad, you will not be given benefit, even if you are worthy, if you are having a merit, if you don't have faith. Suppose I have a faith that whatever going on into this world is good, I will get reward of goodness of this bird. If I don't have faith, I will see everywhere evil. So man must have faith, and the faith is always rewarded, as Lencho has been rewarded because he was having faith in God. So thank you, dear students. This was from my side. If you have any query, you can ask or you can write in comment box. I will reply you. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Dekh lijiye isko, sir.
Sara ka bolne ka.